Go ahead and record. Hare Krishna devotees. So today is the last and final session of Bhagavad Gita, and this is a trailer. I always tell this is like a trailer. So I that you all have already started, and I hope you heard a session and discussion. Somebody who student of so much Prabhu for use, and let's start our scene with Acharan. Before that, I request each one of you to have a paper and a pen, because we will have a self-assessment. So there is no marks, and I'm not going to ask you the marks as well. So, you know, so it's for you. So before, as I said, you know, before we start, so let's start off with Mangalacharan. Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Hare Krishna. Om Anyanatimurandasya Jnananjala Chalakaya Chakshurunnilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. Shri Chaitanya Manobishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaya Dadati Swapadatikam. E Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopeshu Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishabhanusute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpada Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitama Samanibhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabho Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shri Vatsadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna devotees. So our journey, right, last chapter of our Jnana Yoga. So let's hear what Krishna is saying. So it's called the perfection of renunciation. Moksha Sanyasa Yoga, right? So what does he say about moksha, right? That's the purpose. So let's quickly take these sessions. Hare Krishna. So from 1 to 12, Krishna is going to talk about how you can get freedom from bondage through Karma Yoga. Pavanani Manishi Nam, right? Through Karma Yoga, how can you get liberated? The five factors of action we'll be discussing between 13 to 17. Panchaita Tasya Hetavaha, right? And again, coming back to the three modes. The three modes control everything from 18th chapter, 18th verse to 40th. Natad Asti Prithvyam Vya. And purification through Varnashra Dharma. 18.41 to 48. Shreyan Swadharmo Vigunaha, right? And Brahmana platform, confidential knowledge. So what is it they are talking about? 18.49 to 55, Mat Bhaktim Labade Param, right? And we will see each one of it. So now, as I said, this is also a lot of jnana. So it will be technical, but as we explain and as we dive into the chapters, it will become very easy for you. Pure Bhakti is acting in Krishna consciousness, which we will see from 18.56 to 66. Sarva Dharmyam Parityaga. So what is he talking about? Right? What about other religions? So he's going to talk about abandon all religions. And conclusion is 67 to 78. Talks about the four benefits you get by associating yourself with, you know, Arjuna, Krishna, you know, this combo. So it says, Yatra Yogeshwaro Krishna. So Yatra, so this is a very beautiful shloka. It's the last shloka. Now, I will come to that later, and whoever wants to read, as usual, can unmute. Hare Krishna. So, 18.1, as usual, Arjuna is starting. Arjuna Uvacha. Arjuna Uvacha Sanyasasya Mahabaho Tattvam Ichchami Veditum Tyagasya Cha Hrishikesha Takeshini Sudana. Hare Krishna.
Arjuna said, O mighty armed one, I wish to understand the purpose of renunciation and of the renounced order of life. O killer of Keshi Daman, Rishikesha. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Killer of Rishikesha, right? Rishikesha means controller of senses. So what is he talking about? Talking about Krishna. Purpose of renunciation is Tyaga, right? And renounced order of life is Sannyasa. So he says, I would like to understand what is renunciation and what is the purpose of that? And what is the actual renounced order, right? So he is telling, please, explain this to me is what he Arjuna is asking Krishna. So now Krishna is going to explain. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Kamyanam Karmanam Nyasam Sanyasam Kavayo Viduhu Sarva Karma Palatyagam Rahustyagam Vichakshanah.
Hare Krishna, the Supreme Lord said to give up the results of all activities. Mataji,
it's called renunciation.
It's called renunciation, Tyaga, by the wise. And that state is called the renounced order of life, sannyasa, by great learned men. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, thank you. So what they are telling, he's now going to explain what is Tyaga, renunciation. He says, to give up the results of all the activities, right? The results, if you give up, that is called Tyaga. And if you're, and that particular style, right, that renounced order of life, that lifestyle, we use that language, right, that is called sannyasa. Who's saying this? By great learned men are saying this. So in, let's see what 18.3 is saying. So let's have more clarity in it, because it's one liner is very difficult, right? It's like scratching my head. So let's see what he says here. Hare Krishna.
Some learned man declared that all kinds of fruitive activities should be given up. But there are yet other stages to maintain the acts of sacrifice, charity, and penance should never be abandoned. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. This is a very beautiful explanation. He says everything should be given up. What should be given up? Only fruitive activity. But no point in time you should give up or sacrifice. Sacrifice. What is sacrifice? Not what you give to someone or not you give up. It is what you give due to Krishna, which makes Krishna happy. So in, Kali Yuga, what is the sacrifice we all do?
Harinam Sankirtan.
Hare Krishna, correct. Sankirtan Yagna. So that is called Hare Krishna Yagna. Just Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And charity, right? To do charity, that should not be given up. Parents, this should not be given up. These three things should not be given up at any cost. That is why you will see such great people, right? You have Madhavacharya. Why even go back and you talk about Madhavendra Puri, such exalted devotees, Haridas Thakur, they never gave up the sacrifice. They were chanting continuously till the last moment, right? So he says, you should never give up that. So let's hear what 18.5 has to say. Hare Krishna. Dana tapa karma natyajam evatar. Yagno dhanam tapas cheva pavanani shinam. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Sacrifice, charity and penance are not to be given up, but should be performed. Indeed, sacrifice, charity and penance purify even the great soul. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So he says, acts of sacrifice, charity, and penance are not to be given up, but should be performed. Indeed, sacrifice, charity, and penance, why are they done? It's used to purify. So if somebody is already pure, why do they do? It's important, right? To continue to keep it pure. So therefore, it is to be done. It's mandatory, right? So, and what is the, what should be done and what should be the expectation? We already saw, right? So we're going to see a recap of this. 18th chapter is going to be a recap of the most important verses, right? So let's read it again. Hare Krishna in 18.6. Etanyapi tu karmani sangam tyatva palani cha kartavyani ti me prarta nischitam matam uttamam. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. All these activities should be performed without
any exception of result. They should be performed as a matter of duty. O son of path, That is my final opinion. Hare Krishna.
So he's very clearly saying, whatever you do, it should be done without any expectation, right? It should be done as a matter of duty, right? That's my final opinion. So he's saying it should be performed without any expectation. So this person is going to save his lamp, not because he I have a friend who used to be very helpful, right? And she always used to tell, I would like to help because there is a saying that if you take care of everybody or everybody's children, somebody will take care of my child, which is good, no doubt. It's a good thing. But there is an expectation somewhere built into it, right? I want to be good. I like to be good. This is a different mood. But you just do something, right? Don't expect anything at all. Not from the person, right? What you do comes back to you, will automatically work, even if you don't expect. So 18.7, 8 and 9 shlokas. So prescribed duties you don't do. The reason is you're in the illusion, right? So you don't do your prescribed duties because you assume a lot of things. For example, I will give you an example. I don't want to follow shastras because shastras are man-made, right? This is an illusion. It's a wrong thing, right? There is, I came across one person who said, I don't want to read Bhagavad Gita because if you read Bhagavad Gita, we have to follow the rules. Because if you don't follow after reading Bhagavad Gita, then you know it's wrong, right? So whether you read Bhagavad Gita or not read Bhagavad Gita, you have to follow the rules, right? Can you drive a car on the wrong side and tell the police, hey, police, I'm so sorry, I didn't read your law. So please excuse me. Is it going to be an excuse? Your ignorance is not a solution, right? So you need to learn or read Bhagavad Gita because that's a life manual. Not Bhagavad Gita or whether you read Bhagavad Gita, either case, if you don't follow the rules, you're going to be punished. Like, okay, I don't want to know the rules. I will go bang someone. And after I bang, that's fine. But I don't want to be prepared. You know why? Because when I bang, like, it's not the way we talk, right? Because there is this civil law. The law has to be bound. Law to law, you follow is different. You either follow the civil rule or you follow the criminal. Choice is yours. Same way with respect to Krishna. You either follow Krishna in the positive way or you follow in the form of Yamaraj or Maya Devi. Eventually, you follow something. Right? So which one you want to follow, right? It's our choice. Now, some people do not follow the prescribed duties, right? Because of the fear, as I just was telling, right? It's difficult. For example, you know, for typical classic examples, for barren women, you'll see the standard lesson is, I am scared. I don't know what my husband will tell. I have to please my mother-in-law, my father-in-law. You know, I don't want to go against them. That is one thing. Second thing is, if I do not follow what I've been doing, you know, from childhood, I have this practice. So should I change? Now I'm scared. So these are in the mode of passion. Standard answer I give is, are we so obedient? Don't we fight for anything else in our life ever? We do, right? So when we want something in life, we fight. We fight with our friends. We fight with our parents. We fight with our neighbors. We fight because we need something so badly. So if we want something so badly, we will definitely fight to get it. Even if you don't fight it out deep inside your heart, if you have that feeling, Krishna will give that to you. He will ensure everything is set. Okay, 18.9, Hare Krishna, prescribed duties, right? You follow as a matter of duty. Do the duty and that you follow, that's important. He says, right, Krishna is telling Arjuna, nimitta matram means what? You're just an instrument, right? You just duty and I will take care. And someone who does that, Krishna automatically credits, right? So let's see what Krishna says in 18.13 and 14. Hare Krishna, go ahead.
Oh, mighty armed Arjuna, learn from me of the five factors which bring about the accomplishment of all action. These are declared in Sankhya philosophy to be the place of action, the performer, the senses, the endeavor, and ultimately the super soul. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So he's telling, see, look how he's appreciating Arjuna, right? Again, he says, oh, mighty armed Arjuna. So you know, he's like keeping Arjuna in high spirit all the time. He says, learn from me of the five factors, right, which are important. What are the five factors? One is a place of action, where place you do. This is declared in Sankhya philosophy. Who's taught, what is Sankhya philosophy? Sankhya philosophy is taught in depth in Srimad Bhagavatam. We also had a gist of Sankhya philosophy in chapter 2. I'm not the body, I'm the soul. All these technicalities will be a part of Sankhya philosophy. So we learn about the action, you know, the performer, the senses, and the endeavor, right? Efforts are important, right? And ultimately the super soul. Even if you put efforts, you'll have two people studying same hours, same efforts, same background, but you'll see one person achieve. It is because ultimately super soul is also has to play his role. So this is what it is. Action, you have a person who's a performer, the senses which are in control, endeavor is your effort, and finally are Krishna, super soul. So let me just, we will understand in a couple of shlokas. In 18.18, we'll have clear examples. Until then, let's read 18.16. Hare Krishna.
Therefore, one who thinks himself the only dole, not considering the five factors, is certainly not very intelligent and cannot see things as they are. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Ritu, Anjali, one of you all can read the next shloka. I mean, next content. So let me tell this. So the the next one. So let me explain this. Thank you. So therefore, one who thinks himself as the only doer, he thinks that I am the doer. We've all come across these people. No, I have done. I am a self-made man. I can do everything on my own. Have you heard this? I've heard it enough and more number of times. So such a person who does not consider the five factors is definitely not intelligent. He perceives him to be intelligent, but he is not. And cannot see things as they are because he thinks he is a doer, but he completely forgets the other things which are around him. So let's read 18.18 and you will understand. Yeah, you can go ahead and read, Ma. Hare Krishna. Yes, Ritu.
Knowledge, the object of knowledge and the knower of knower are the three factors which motivate action. The senses, the work and the doer comprise the threefold basis of action. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So now we are talking about knowledge, right? So tada, one brain, that is knowledge, right? It's going to the head. The object of knowledge is what? The object of knowledge in this case is the ball, right? So that is the object which he's targeting. And the knower is the person, right? And what happens? The three factors will motivate the action. He is going to be motivated by the particular action. The senses are working, the work and the doer comprises of this threefold. So they're introducing three characters, three things, which is the knowledge, the object and the knower, right? So the three things. Now it's time for self-assessment. Paper, pencil, please. Tell me once you are ready. This is a scoring, not an exam. It's a self-evaluation. You don't have to give me marks. You don't have to share in the group, but please make a note. One being the lowest and three being the highest. It's not rank. First rank is highest. No. Here opposite. One is lowest and three is the highest. I would request each one of you all to do, including my co-host, because it's an amazing evaluation factor. So are you ready? Yes, no. Need a second for picking up a paper pencil. If not paper pen, anything is okay. But need a paper. Tell me, good to go?
Yes.
Good to go? Okay, start. Please don't give decimal marks. Mark yourself closest to whatever suits you, right? So 3, 2, 1. As I said, 3 being the highest. Now the 5 areas which we spoke, we discussed in depth. Right. So each one of you all can go ahead. I would suggest one will read 18.20. One will read 18. Like Vaibhav, you read hereafter the first column. The second column, Vijay Kumari can read. And third column, you know, Ritu, you can read. Anybody wants to read, please let me know. Besides you three. Hare Krishna. So I'm
going to do this. Am I going to write which one?
You will read the first one. Every time the first column, you will read the second. And after you read, just give a pause. I'll explain. The second column will be Vijay Kumari Mataji, and the third one will be Ritu Mataji. Yeah. Hare Krishna. Three kinds of knowledge based on the modes of nature, right? So here we are going to talk about three kinds of knowledge. So let's see 18.20. Hare Krishna.
That knowledge by which one undivided spiritual nature is seen in all existence undivided in the divided is knowledge in the mode of goodness. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So what are they saying? The knowledge which is undivided, right? Somebody where you don't see a difference at all. Everything is one. So if you feel this kind of a knowledge you get, for example, a classic example is we saw Dhira in chapter 2. We also read about Uttama Adhikari. We saw about faith, right? We saw the Shraddha, which we were noticing in the last module. Right. So all these things are for someone, you know, where he sees this kind of a spirit, everything is in spiritual nature, right? If you are of this category, rank yourself clean. So if not, just wait and let's wait for Vijay Kumari Mataji to read 18.21. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. That knowledge by which a different type of living entity is seen to be dwelling in different modes, different bodies, is knowledge in the mode of passion. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, thank you. The knowledge by which a different type of living entity is seen, right? For example, this person sees everyone differently. He knows, he has the knowledge. Classic example is, you know, we all come in this category. Of course, rank as per what you think is apt. You know, we all now understand I'm not the body and the soul, right? So we know there's different person, right? I am a different person. Here, Mohandas Prabhuji is different. Now, forget the person here. There is a cat in your house, it's different. Dog in your house is different. You have different ways of living, at least seen in different bodies, right? This particular knowledge means you're in mode of passion. You know it exists. You can't see equally. Like in mode of goodness, you see everyone equal, right? You see there's Paramatma. Here, you know, acha, okay, this is a dog, this is a rat, this is a Indian, this is a Telugu person, right? So that happens. So that kind of a thing will be in the mode of passion. So now let's see, you know, like for example, there was an act. Incidentally, there was once when we went shopping, right? And incidentally, our entire family, we had gone and we wanted to pick up a comforter. But in this shop, the comforter was very nice, but they were not giving away the comforters. The comforters were to be bought only if there is a purchase which had to be done, right? So if the purchase met a particular criteria, then you can buy a comforter at an incremental cost. So there was one, you know, we were thinking, okay, just for speaking of pick something else which we don't want to buy, right? So like Nectar of Instruction says that, right? So we should not try and add things which are not required. So it says, you know, that is very unwanted. So therefore, what is he saying? He's saying, so there was one Mataji, she was very nice. She just came forward on her own and she said, you know, I have taken a huge bill. You retain the bill and you can pick the comforter because I don't need it. And she gave the bill and she left. So this is an amazing act of the person, right? Because normally people don't overhear. And then she said, it's okay. And she said, thank you. And, you know, she was a Telugu because so the moment you saw, the first thing which went, this, oh, she's very nice because, okay, I'm a Telugu. So basically our family is Telugu. So immediately what they said, oh, so nice she is, you know, she's a Telugu, that's why. So can you see, this is called mode of passion. You can relate someone to your kind. So anyway, she's done a good act. So irrespective of what it is, you know, now you want to take a little bit of credit into your account, right? And you try and match. You're actually, you're not doing anything wrong, but then you're trying to relate, you know, and this is a very common thing. When you go abroad, you have someone helping you. Immediately you'll ask, are you're from India? No, you're Pakistan. So immediately, Pakistan also border. Na? So your idea itself will change. Your view itself will change. As long as you're in India, you will see India and Pakistan as two different, you know, you'll be in longitudes. Whereas if you're abroad, they'll say, are, okay, once upon a time, Pakistan also were part of India. What am I trying to tell is you try and see they are different. But you try and see something in common and relate, right? So that's called linkages, mode of passion. So let's move on to 18.22. Hare Krishna, on to you, Ritu. And if you are in this category, sorry, Ritu. If you are in this category, rate yourself too. Please don't move away. Just wait and rate. Yes, Ritu, please go ahead.
And that knowledge by which one is attached to one kind of work as the all in all without knowledge of the truth, and which is very meager, is said to be in the mode of darkness. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. And that knowledge, right, by which one is attached to one kind of work, only one kind of work, and all in all, right, without knowledge of the truth, without even knowing the truth, which is absolute, and which is very meager, right, which is very small, is said to be in the mode of darkness. I wanted to explain this to you, absolute. Why do we call absolute, and we call all of us relative? Absolute means sambhutam, which means independent. We were reading, right? You know, I am independent self. There's nothing called self-made man except one who's Krishna. He is the only self-made. Self-made because he or is swayam, he is on his own. There is no beginning, there is no end. So other than that, everything is asambhutam, which means we are dependent on Krishna. So independent is called absolute. Everything and every one of us are dependent. So we are called relative, right? So there is an original, Everything other than that becomes relative. It could be sun, it could be moon, it could be star, it could be my outfit, it could be me. Everything is relative to the absolute. And our existence is meager if we can't relate. So that is why it goes like this. Andam tama pravishyanti eya sambhutyam upashate tato bhuya ivate tamo yahu sambhutyam ratah. Which means that only Krishna. So if you pray him, you know, you go and reach him. Otherwise, you go to various destinations wherever you pray. Why did I bring this here? It's because the knowledge by which one is attached to the work, right? Without knowing the absolute, which is knowing the truth here refers to Krishna, right? Is very meager and therefore he is in darkness. So Andha means he is total darkness, right? So this is the three kinds of knowledge. Wherever you have knowledge, you can mark yourself three as the highest, one as the lowest. Now let's move on to next one, right? So the three of actions based on the modes of material nature. So again, we have based on actions, right? So this is based on our actions. So whatever is based on action. So you can go ahead and read. Hare Krishna.
As for action, that action in accordance with duty, which is performed without attachment, without love or hate, by one who has renounced fruitive results, is called action in the mode of goodness. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So he's saying, as far as the actions are concerned, which is in accordance with the duty, right? You're doing it as per your duty, without any attachment, without love or hatred, right? By one who has renounced the fruitive results, he's not bothered, he's just doing it. Example, somebody wants to study, you have an aim of medicine or engineering, which is fine. It's not wrong, but then you move to passion. But someone who says that, okay, I will study and give my best 100%, right? That becomes mode of goodness. That's my duty, so I'm studying. I have four subjects to study. I will just study. I'm not going to break my head how much marks I'm going to get. That's too much of stress. Whether I like this subject or not, whether I like the teacher or not, right? Without love or hatred, without any attachment, I will perform a duty. Even as some of them, you know, do it for their parents, right? I want to serve my parents. I like them, I do not like them, I will just do them without love or hatred, right? And even when it comes to doing, you know, our homework and assignment, let me share. I used to love biology till 8th standard. 9th standard, I started hating biology. Why? Because I didn't like the teacher. Any experiences or am I alone? So I don't like this teacher, so I started hating biology and I decided I don't want to do anything related to biology because I didn't like the teacher. So can you see a duality here? So if I like biology or not, this has to be mine, right? It should not be, Anjali, if you want to read, you can go ahead and read. After I finish. Yeah,
but
yeah.
So, action perform.
Wait, one second. After I finish, sweetheart, 1 second.
Okay.
So therefore, by one who has renounced fruitive actions, right? I will just give up everything said to be in the mode of goodness, right? So that quality is what, and if you are there, please rate yourself 3. And now on to you. Next one, Hare Krishna.
But action performed with great effort by one seeking to gratify his desires and which is enacted from a sense of false ego is called action in the mode of passion. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So when you say but action performed with great effort, right? You put so much effort with satisfying your senses. You have to be a doctor. I want because my cousin is a doctor. That's my desire. I want to fulfill. It could be any desire. It could be my desire or it can be my mother's desire, but eventually you want to satisfy your senses, right? And it is also enacted from a sense of false ego. I want to do engineering because my entire family is that of engineers and it's my prestige. I just can't do anything less than an engineer. I have to have MBA because you know everyone has done only UG and I want to be one law child. You may have a reason to do MBA. That's a different thing. It's not wrong. But I'm just telling these kind of desires which gratify your senses, right? They are coming under the mode of passion. Right, so let's hear the 18.24. And don't forget that, just start marking. No right or wrong answer, it's not pass or fail. So go ahead. 18.24.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. And that action performed in ignorance and delusion without consideration of future bondage or consequences which inflicts injury and is impractical is said to be action in the mode of ignorance.
Hare Krishna. So they say that and that action performed in ignorance, right? I'm totally ignorant. and I'm in delusion, I'm in confusion without any consideration of future, right? I don't know. No future consequence, even if it inflicts injury. Some people do things which can be injurious to self or someone, right? And it is totally impractical. It's said to be in the mode of action, mode of ignorance. Example, you take Ravana or Hiranyakashipu. They did so many things, right, without even considering what can be the consequence. Hiranyakashipu would have never thought that if he had so much of power, he would land up killing his own child. Right? It inflicts injury not only to son, to himself, because killing a child is so difficult, but he was so much in the mode of ignorance. He wanted to gain control over Vishnu that he wanted to kill Vishnu. Leave the fact that he wanted to kill. The fact is he was even willing to kill his own son. So what is the level of ignorance? What is his power for? Right? And is such action... Right now, time for your scoring. So please score yourself. 3 being the highest and 1 being the lowest. Ta-da, ta-da, please rank. So let's see these are workers based on the modes of material nature. So workers based on material nature, what is this? Let's see the first worker, person in action.
The worker who is free from all material attachments and face ego, who is enthusiastic and resolved and who is indifferent to success or failure is a worker in a mode of goodness. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So the worker who is free from material attachment, right? Why? Because Kama Esha, Krodha Esha, right? If you're away from this Kama, Krodha, only then you will be able to go to the next level. And who is enthusiastic and resolute, right? Resolute means completely fixed in Krishna consciousness. And who is indifferent to success or failure? Okay, I will study. Doesn't matter. I'm studying. Let me see the result. I will put my 100%. There's no compromise there because you're not renunciation to work. You're only renunciating the action, right? So you're not going to tell that I don't want to study. I close my book because Krishna told no. Krishna never told that. Krishna told get up and fight, right? So you get up and study. But what you do is you renunciate the result. Irrespective, I put my 100%. Whatever result comes is fine, right? And indifferent to success or failure, whether you're successful or failure, that is what it is. Such a person is in the mode of goodness, right? So that's what 18.26 says. And let's see if you fall in that category, put rank yourself 3. Otherwise, let's see what 2 has to say in 18.27. Hare Krishna.
But that worker who is attached to the fruits of his labor and who passionately wants to enjoy them, who is greedy, envious, and impure, and moved by happiness and distress, is a worker in the mode of passion. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, someone who's attached to the result. Oh, okay, I'm going to work because I will get some increment or I get some status. So I am, my social need is taken care. I can't tolerate. Someone said, no, how can I get rid of envy? So now it's coming, right? I'm so envious. This person has reached this. So I will work so that I can beat this person. Very impure, right? Moved by, if immediately happy, I'll jump to the roof. I'm sad, I'll sit and moan. I'll be crying till I come out. I just can't come out. Such a person is said to be in the mode of passion, right? So that is what it is said in 18.27. So let's...
Hare Krishna, Madhuri.
Hare Krishna.
I think Ritu Mataji has got a doubt. I think she's put in the chat.
Maybe. Yes, we will hold the doubts till the end. So doubts, we take it at the end of the class. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. And that worker who is always engaged in work against the injection of the scripture, who is mantistic obeisance, chatting, cheating and expert in insulting others, who is lazy, always morse and procrastinating is a worker in the mode of ignorance. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So anyone, Ritu, you're okay, right? I'll answer your question at the end. Or if it's super urgent, you can type in the chat. So as I'm finishing this, I will just read the answer. I mean, I'll read your doubt and answer in the course. And that worker who's always engaged in the work against the injection of scripture. So he does work right opposite to the scriptures, right? Whatever. Thank you, Ritu. So whatever is mentioned against the scripture, that's not right, right? Who's materialistic? You will see they are so strongly materialistic. They will tell, this is my house, it's my phone. You know, they are so addicted that they won't be able to tolerate even the basic things. My phone, don't use. My laptop, don't touch. My room, don't enter. those are very materialistic people, right? And they are very, they have a high cheating propensity. Okay, and they are experts in insulting others. You know, they will be very sarcastic. Sarcastic for fun is different, but I'm talking about someone who's like seriously sarcastic. They'll be extremely lazy and always morose. They will be like having a face where, you know, you don't feel like seeing their face. Oh my God, you know, you feel like putting a huge mirror right before the face and telling them, hey, you know what, look at your face because we have to look at you 24/7. So just do procrastinating, always postponing, right? There are categories who keep procrastinating. He is in the work and the mode of ignorance, complete ignorance, right? So that category is what is there. So therefore, come on, start scoring 3. If you have no material attachment, you have immense attachment, you get a score of 1. And therefore, if you are attached to the fruits, you want to enjoy the fruits, then you can give yourself 2. So now 3 kind, I hope you've scored, so I can go to the next, which means 3 kinds of intelligence based on the modes of material nature. So let's hear what 18.30 Krishna is saying.
O son of Parth, that understanding by which one knows who ought to be done and what ought not to be done, which is to be feared and what is not to be feared, what is binding and what is liberating, that understanding is established in the mode of goodness. Hare Krishna.
O son of Partha, that understanding by which one knows what ought to be done and what ought not to be done. Right? What is to be done? What is not to be done? What is to be feared? What is not to be feared is very important, right? So I had one particular devotee who said that, you know, I am scared to understand shastras because it gives me fear. But that fear is healthy, right? So when you do something, for example, you know, when your parents are there and let's say that you don't want to study, you want to take a break, but still you're scared, you know, you just want to, you know, you're telling the guy, yeah, okay, and you're scared. You know, you're scared, you like a person and you are scared. These are very scared to tell your parents. These are respect forms. These are not about inability. These are actually healthy fears, right? I am not taking a bath. I don't feel like going to the temple. I'm scared, you know. These are very healthy. I've done a mistake. I feel guilty to see Krishna. Those fears are healthy fears, right? They are, and what, which one knows what is to be done, what is not to be, do's and do's. We already saw this, right? Pravritti and nivritti. And such things are, what is it? It's liberating, right? Such a thing establishes what one in the mode of goodness. So these are clarity in the mode of goodness. So you're using your intelligence, right? Intelligence is about mind. So that is the higher platform, right? You use your intelligence to control your mind. So there, you know, you have all this. So let's hear what 18.31 has to say. Hare Krishna.
And that understanding, which cannot distinguish between the religious way of life and the irreligious, between action and that should be done and action that should not be done, that imperfect understanding, O son of Pratha, is in the mode of passion. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So this person is very confused. What is to be done? What is, you will see a lot of people, typically us, na? We're so confused. Should I do or not do? Somebody is telling us to do, somebody is telling us not to do. Classic example is timing. Right? This is an inauspicious time. Don't worry. Should I follow or not follow? I'm very confused. Why? Because we have not read the Shastras. We don't know what is there. So this reminds me of a story and a place in Kerala, where in Kerala, what happened is at the time of wedding in a particular village, they used to lock a cat every time before the wedding. So they constantly, So they constantly used to keep searching for the cat at the time of wedding. And one day they were just not able to execute the ritual because they could not find the cat. They went on and on and on. And why did they do that? Because of the fact that many years ago, there used to be a lot of cat population. And because the cats used to cause distress, they used to take the cat and put them in a cage before they execute anything. So that habit came in again. So that was done more of a comfort factor or convenience factor, but that became a practice that there was a stage when there was no cat and people were searching. So same way as earlier, right? Earlier, black cats used to be considered bad because they never had electricity. And after 6 p.m., if the cat was black, they won't know whether they're stepping on the cat or they're stepping and falling down, what harm they do to yourself and to the cat. So they used to consider that any black cat was inauspicious. But even today, they find it. What is the difference between black? You have a black hair. So should we say that, okay, black is inauspicious, therefore we very good, no, right? We immediately color our hair and keep it black. Yes or no? May not be now because you all are young, but then as you get older, you know, I see a lot of my aunts and uncles trying to explore a lot of colors, and they keep telling this one, that one. Sooner or later, I think I will also start using it. So what happens is that becomes very important, right? So black, if it is inauspicious, then why are we trying to put black? Why do we want to have black eyebrows? Why do we want to have black pupil? Why do we want to have black hair? So these are sentiments which are not there anywhere written. But these are things which are followed over time and we are so confused. So that category is part of passion. So let's now move on to ignorance. Hare Krishna.
That's understanding
which considers irreligion to be religion and religion to be irreligion. Under the spell of illusion and darkness, and strives always in the wrong direction. O Pritha is the mode of ignorance. Hare Krishna.
O Partha. Pritha means you are calling Kunti. Here you are talking about Arjuna.
So O Partha.
Yeah, yeah. So Partha is son of Pritha, right? Kunti Devi is Pritha. So he is Partha. So what are they telling? Understanding in this, this is even worse. Irreligion is religion and religion is irreligion. There are a lot of people who say, are what your shastras are written by man? All this is ignorance. Right? I met a person who said that, you know, in this movie, there is this hero, Rajinikanth. What he says, I believe. You know, I blindly follow him. Are he himself will not be following what he says because he is just a voice box of what dialogue is given to him. Right? He may be a great actor, but what is his role? He is an actor who follows the instruction of the director. He's doing his duty. He may not even mean what he says because he just reads the script which is given to him. And the script is written probably not by the director, but by some dialogue writer. And look at the level of foolishness of the person who says that I will blindly follow him. Who is he? He's one person who's subject to errors, right? Because he's a human and he's not even following him. He's following somebody whose dialogue he follows. So can you see? Such people consider religion as irreligion because they don't know and consider irreligion, right, as religion because they want to follow something. What is religion? Religion is dharma. And you're talking about celebrity dharma. So how do you call that, right? So can you see this kind of people are in the highest mode of ignorance? So now, sweethearts, take your pen and pencil and where is your intelligence? 3, 2, 1. Are you done scoring yourself? If so, we'll go to determination. Very important point. Very important for all of us to be determined. Kind of determination 18.33 should. Hare Krishna.
O son of Pritha, that determination which is unbreakable, which is sustained with steadfastness by yoga practice, and is controlled by the mind, life, and acts of the senses, is the mode of goodness.
Hare Krishna. So he says, son of Partha, which is unbreakable, Shraddha, Uttamadhikari, whatever you tell him about Krishna, how much ever you speak, he is so clear that you cannot even shake his thing. Unlike us who are neophytes, somebody tells, oh, Krishna is light. Oh, maybe Krishna is light. Maybe light is more powerful. Maybe God is one and that God is light, doesn't have a structure. All this kind of doubt. No, somebody can speak to us for 10 minutes, we'll be totally convinced. Right? So that is why we are called neophyte. And they are called Uttamadhikar. They are the highest level. So let's see somebody in the mode of passion. We'll see that. Let's read 18.34. Hare Krishna.
And that determination by which one holds fast to fruitive result in religion, economic development, and sense gratification is of the nature of passion. O Arjuna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So what is dharma artha? Dharma is religion, economic development is artha, right? And sense gratification is kama. So he's saying who holds fast, right? They who are so focused, politics, nature, sense gratification, business, running around, all this, whoever tries hard will be coming under the mode of passion. And let's see what is mode of ignorance. Ignorance is very clear. We will only be confused with passion. We will be very clear about goodness and ignorance. We're too extreme. Passion is only the cutting line because if you gum this side, you go to goodness. And if you slip this side, you go to ignorance. Yes, Kana. 18.34. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. And that determination which cannot go beyond dreaming, fearfulness, lamentation, moroseness, and illusion. Such unintelligent determination is in the mode of darkness. Hare Krishna.
So he says that determination which cannot go beyond dreaming, right? He was only capable of dreaming. You heard, right? Cousins in air. He will tell, I want to do so much, so much, so much, but always in the mobile. We'll be dreaming only. Daydreamer, we say. Always scared, always lamenting, crooping. Oh my God, why me? Why this to me? Oh my God, had I not had COVID, I would have got symptom. Had I not had my relative come just on the day of exam, you know, no doubt, you know, all this. So I, all these lot of serious things are different, but there are some small, very silly things. Hey, you know, correctly, you know, that day, you know, that person, India lost against Pakistan. I lost my mood. Yeah. Had India won, you know, I would have just hit the roof. Can you see a lot relating? Because sometimes even I am like this. Can you relate? Yeah. Any of you all are able to relate? Thank you, Ritu. Hare Krishna. So sweet. I love that honest confessions. Huh? Because that is what we are all lacking. At least we have to admit to ourselves where we lack. Only then we'll be able to try and fix. So all these things, always morose. Oh my God. You know, I've seen some categories who say, I will smile. Only, I will not be thinking of this. I will smile only after my problem is resolved. I will tell, Hare Krishna, this is Dukalyam, Ashashvitam. It's temporary world, but it's a Dukalyam. So where will you smile ever? You will have one Dukam following another, right? Such unintelligent determination is supposed to be in the mode of darkness. Now, ranking 3-1. I love this chapter. Okay, now, all of you finish scoring. I will not show the result. Now, can you add? You all are fast in adding. Kada, fata, fata, add, that dumb. So now let's see our score. You don't have to share. Near 18. If you're near 18, then it's good. If you're near 6, not so great. If you're 12, you have to mode of passion. Time for you to do hard work. Why? If you're 18, you're in mode of goodness, you have to maintain. If you're 6, please, yeah, you have to really work hard. 12, you know, you have to maintain. That's more challenging. So why am I showing? You don't have to share your results, but it's for yourself only. This exercise, we have to do at the beginning. Because only if we do at the beginning, you know, by now in 18 days, things have changed and maybe being at lower scores and we'll go up. True, it's nice, but your 18 day can give your score up. Then imagine how much your advanced course can do and imagine how much of reading of Bhagavad Gita will do. My only request is please read at least one shloka a day. Bhagavad Gita, not a day of mine goes by without me reading Bhagavatam also. Bhagavatam is a lot of fun. It's like story. Have you had people saying that if you have not done the shopping or if you have not to this place, you've really lost out in life? Trust me, if you don't read Bhagavatam, you've really, really lost out something in life. That I can tell you with the guarantee. Right? What is this 18.2? Flashback. Okay, so this is 18.20, which says that knowledge by which one undivided spiritual nature is seen in the entity. So everywhere, whether it's a cat or a dog or a thing, you see everything with an equal vision, right? He is a Uttama Adhikari. What is special about 33? He says the determination which is unbreakable, steadfast. You see Prabhupada, he went with 40 rupees. Can you believe 40 Indian rupees in a cargo ship and had 2 heart attack at the age of 69? I would not know what to do. I would have first of all not gone with 40 rupees. Second, I would have not known, I would have probably jumped out of the river or whatever. I mean, see, and someone told him, like, let's shift you into another place. He said, no, Krishna has destined, I will continue this journey. Right? So now we are going to another chapter. 4 kinds of ashram. We saw Varna ashram, Varnas and ashram. Varna is Brahmin, Kshatriya, you know, and Vaishya and Sudra. Ashrama, the first 25 years is Brahmins, Brahmacharya. Sorry, the next 25, which is 26 to 50. Talks about grahastha, which means he's married, he has children. Next 25 is, you know, vanaprastha, that means he will go and with his wife to various devotional places. And ashrama is, sannyasa is the last 25, where he will leave his family and he will go completely in search of. Yes, Vaibhav, Varna is a caste system. Varna is not the caste system which we are talking about here. Here we are talking about the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and all. So when someone says caste system, I used to be so angry because I used to have a friend of mine. We were a small gang who used to tell, oh, what's your score? Even if I get this much mark, you know, that's in 12th. She used to tell, oh, even if I get choose a scheduled caste. So there is this quota system. Her father was a professor. So they had a very good family line, financially strong. But she used to tell that, you know, I just need to get 75%, not even 75, I get 65, 70, there is quota everywhere. They have to give me seat because they have this quota system. So we used to be like, oh my God. And every time she used to come and rub it on us, she used to tell, that. So if someone tells caste system, you know, it's more like a psyche for me. I'm sure many of y'all would have had a similar experience. So Varnashram is caste system, not for you to go, but it's for based on your quality. So a Brahmana is more on the softer side, who's very intelligent, knowledgeable, and he can share knowledge because he has devotional knowledge naturally. A Kshatriya is a protector. He has to swing, which you're going to read now. He needs to have that power and vigor to go and protect someone. You know, not like us, you know, they tell in our house, hey, they are fighting, forget it. No, it's not our problem. Let's shut the door and come inside. No, 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 that's not the thing. So these are ashram based on quality. And if it's not mandatory, you have to stick to that ashram, though it is healthy. But if there is a particular quality, like Parshuram was a Brahmana, but his quality of a Kshatriya was more. So he did go and learn a lot of military art. So more related to your quality and not by birth. So even if you're a Brahmin and if you're fit, not to be Ashwatthama, he's not a fit Brahmin, he didn't follow at all, right? So he's not, he's considered a Duvabanju. He's considered as a Dujabanju, which means a friend of a Brahmana, which means as good as useless. Right. So let's read what 18.5 that will answer your question. Hare Krishna. Samo dhamastapah saucham shantir arjavam evacha jnanam vinyanam ashtikyam brahma karma swabhavam jam. Hare Krishna.
Peacefulness, self-control, austerity, purity, tolerance, honesty, wisdom, knowledge, and religiousness. These are the qualities by which the Brahmins work.
Hare Krishna, thank you. Very clearly, right? So Brahmanas, now you saw, right? Brahmanas are following these things, purity, tolerance. So if the qualities are not there, you're not a Brahmin, even if you're born in a Brahmin family. So these are the qualities of Brahmin. Let's see what the Kshatriya's qualities are. Hare Krishna. Sauryam tejo dhritir dakshyam yute chapi apalayanam danam ishvara bhavascha kshatram karma swabhavajam. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Heroism, power, determination, resourcefulness, courage in battle, generosity and leadership are the qualities of work for the Kshatriyas. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So clearly they are telling heroism, right? So he has to go and strike. He has to have leadership quality. He has to have the courage. These are the qualities of Kshatriya, not anything else. And let's see what 18.44 he says. Hare Krishna. Rishi Gorakshyavanityam Vaishakarma Swabhavajam Paricharyatmakam Karma Sudrashyapi Swabhavajam.
Farming, cattle raising and business are the qualities of work for the Vaishyas, and for the Shudras there is labor and service to others. Hare Krishna.
And what do Sudras do? They are like the legs because they support the three pillars and they act. This is what it is, right? Brahmanas, they spread knowledge. Kshatriyas have the vigor. Vaishyas protect and, you know, Sudras are, yeah, protect. And the Sudras actually serve these people for them to facilitate the work. Hare Krishna.
Yata pravriti bhutanam yena sarvaidam tatam Swakarmanatam abhyarcha siddhim bindati manavaha.
Hare Krishna.
By worship of the Lord, who is the source of all beings and who is the preventing man, can win the performance of his own duty, attain perfection. Hare Krishna.
Clearly, the Lord, right? So he's telling who's the source of all beings, right? He's the one. And why is Varnashrams created? For the purpose of purification. He says that in the fourth chapter, right? Who is pervading man, right? And in performing his own duty, right? He does his own duty, he will attain perfection. That is the purpose. And this is told in the fourth chapter. Arjuna says, Krishna, what if they believe in Devatas? You know, he says, no problem. Let them do. But how will they get purified? Let them follow the Varnashram. Automatically, you will get purified. And that's why is this in 18.47, it's clearly said, Hare Krishna. Shreyan swadharmo vigunaha paradharmat swanushtitat swabhavaniyatam karma kurvanapnoti kilbisham. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. It is better to engage in one's occupation. One's occupation, even though one may perform it imperfectly, than to accept another's occupation and perform it perfectly. Prescribed duties according to one's nature are never affected by sinful reactions. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So clearly he is saying that it's better one follows his own occupational duties, right? That is more important rather than engaging in somebody else's duty. Krishna is very clearly telling that. Engage one in your own occupational duty. That is so important, because instead of doing some other duty, even if you're doing it imperfectly, that is what he told Arjuna also. Even if you're doing it imperfectly, please get up and fight. Don't renunciate, run and become a Brahmana, because that's not going to suit you. Even if it suits you, you will set a wrong example. Kindly do not do that, is what he is very clearly saying, right? So that is something which we have to follow. And that is exactly what Krishna will is reiterating, right? All this we've already read. This is like a revision. So let's see what Krishna says here in 18.47. Hare Krishna. Shreyan Swadhar. So what does it mean? Vigunaha. So what they are saying, Paradharma. Para means the supreme truth, is that we cannot treat everyone equal. Take this example of the animals. Can you tell that which animal is great telling by climbing the tree? No. Right? So obviously you will tell it's an unfair game, because you can't, one's qualification is different, one's capabilities are different. So you can't have a race over a wrong example. So that is what Krishna is saying. So let's read what 18.49 says. Hare Krishna.
One can obtain the results of renunciation simply by self-control and by becoming unattached to material things and disregarding material enjoyments. That is the highest professional stage of renunciation. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So one can obtain the results of renunciation simply by self-control, right? By controlling the senses itself, one can become unattached, right? And he will disregard material. That is the highest stage, right? The first question he asks, how can one reach renunciation? Now he's going to explain this a little more. Hare Krishna. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Na Sochati Na Kanchasi Samaha Sarveshu Bhuteshu Mad Bhaktim Labhate Param. Hare Krishna.
One who is thus transcendentally situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman. He never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed to every living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me. Hare Krishna.
He clearly says, one who thus transcends and realizes Supreme Brahman, right? He never laments. No way he laments, right? He is never sad. He never desires to have anything. Why? Because everything is equal, right? We have read this. Krishna tells in the initial chapter 2.14, Matras Pastastu Kaunteya Sitoshi Sukha Dukkadaha Agama Paino Anityas Tamstika Shashvata Bharata. Means, right, irrespective of heat or cold, you should not have any impact, right? You should tolerate. So he's bringing that. Someone who tolerates, who has that quality, right, he attains a pure devotional service. Now giving how they can act in. And this is so nice. This is also mentioned earlier. Let me read this. Hare Krishna. Bhaktya mam abhijanati yamanyas chasmi tatvatah tato mam tatvato nyatva vishate tat anantaram. Hare Krishna.
One can understand the Supreme Personality as he is only by devotional service. And when one is in full consciousness of the Supreme Lord by such a devotion, he can enter into the kingdom of God. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So very clearly he says, one can understand the Supreme Personality. Right? And as he is only by devotional service, right? He can understand the Supreme Person only through devotional service. Nowhere he can, right? Because devotional service is a relationship. And one in full conscious does that, he will automatically reach Krishna. Right? So Krishna will personally come and take the person. So what is the quality in 18.56? He says, Hare Krishna, Sarva karmanyapi sada kurvano mad vyapashraya mad prasadat avapnoti shashvatam padam avyayam. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, though engaged in all kinds of activities, my devotee under my protection reaches the eternal and imperishable abode, my grace. Hare Krishna.
Krishna, can you see there is no one who can give this guarantee except Krishna. Krishna says by doing this, he will reach my abode, which is eternal. Right? Nothing can stop. He is giving guarantee. And 18.58, let's see what he says more. Hare Krishna. Machittah sarva durgani mat prasadatarishyasi atasetvam ahankaram nashoshyasi vinakshyasi. Hare Krishna.
If you become conscious of me, you will pass over all the obstacles of conditional life by my grace. If, however, you do not work in such consciousness but act through false ego, not hearing me, you will be lost. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, it clearly says, if you become conscious of me, you will pass through all the obstacles, right? By grace. If, however, you do not work in that consciousness, but you act through false ego, if you're not hearing me, you will surely be lost. He is saying that. So please don't have ahankar. That's so dangerous and you will fall in the deep pit. So what does he say in 61? Ishvarah sarva bhutanam hriday desi archutishtati brahmayan sarva bhutani yantra rudani mayaya. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, the Supreme Lord is situated in everyone's heart. O Arjuna, and is directing the wanderings of all living entities who are seated as on a machine made of the material energy. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna is clearly saying the Supreme Lord is situated in everybody's heart and directing everybody, right? They are sitting in the machine. He's made up of material energy. So clearly he says this is what it is. And this is like everybody, body is a machine, right? But Krishna is actually seated there. So body is, everybody gets a body according to their need, right? But what is happening? He's seated there. Right? He's just sitting there and wondering as to what he has to achieve. So therefore, this material energy is also, we saw, right? Energy of Krishna mentioned in 7.4, which is his external energy. Now, this picture is, of Jagannath. And it's in Jagannath Puri by Rana Pratap Singh. He's a big Maharaja. But once a year, he does all actions for Krishna, right? He cleans the floor personally. So that is the quality of his thing. He can have servant maids to do it, but he wants to personally do for Krishna. So that is the quality. Let's see this. Tameva sharanam gacha sarvabhavena bharata tatra sadat param shatim sthanam apyasi shashvatam. Hare Krishna.
Most kind of Bharata, surrender unto him utterly. By his grace you will attain the transcendental bliss and the supreme and eternal abode. Hare Krishna.
So very clearly he's telling, the successor of the Bharata, surrender unto him. That's all you need to do. Automatically you will reach the supreme abode. So he's telling the way in which he can reach the supreme abode. So let's see what 18.6463 says. Hare Krishna. Iti te jnanam akshatam guyyad guyyataram maya vimrishyaita dasheshena yatechasi tata kuru. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thus I have explained to you the most confidential of all knowledge. Deliberate on this fully and then do what you wish to do. Hare Krishna.
So he's telling, I've now explained to you everything. Okay, I have completely gone. And then do what you want to do. So look at the thing Krishna has told, and everybody says, why can't Krishna make me do this? Because he doesn't want to treat us like a robot. He wants to treat us like a human. So he's telling, now I have told you, now it's up to you. I have given you two things, right? Money can buy chocolates, ice creams, flowers, everything. That is one side. Money can also buy alcohol, smoke. Right, what you want to do is your choice, right? He is giving you choice, right? Raja Vidya Raja Uttamam. So what does he mean? Vyam, it's a most confidential knowledge and it's a very sacred knowledge of all, and nothing will be equal to that. He cleared the 9th chapter and now he is reiterating this. And let's see what 18.65 he's saying. Krishna, manmana bhava mad bhakto madhyati mam namaskuru mame vaishasti satyam te rati jane priyosi me.
Always think of me and become my devotee. Worship me and offer your homage unto me. Thus you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend.
So he clearly says, always think of me and become my devotee. Worship me, right? Namaskuru. And offer my homage to, right? Thus you will come to me without fail. Why is Krishna telling, is he short of people there? He's Hanta Mani Prakarasatma Sukalpa Vriksha Laksha Diteshu Suravi Abhipalayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Sadasam Brahmya Sevyamanam Adi Purusham Tamam Bajami. Hare Krishna, what does he say? He's got so many lakhs and lakhs of Lakshmi serving him, right? In spite of that, why is he giving us this offer? Because it's a bumper offer for us to change and to go to him. It's not that Krishna is short of people, it's because he asked to be rescued. Hare Krishna, 18.6. Here he is giving actual solution. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami masuchah. Hare Krishna,
abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me. I shall deliver you from all sinful action. Do not fear. Hare Krishna.
So basically, he's very clearly telling, abandon all varieties of religion and surrender to me. So when you had this confusion, right, put the cat in the box. Should I do this? Should I call this day? Some people follow that Tuesday is a bad day. It is called Mangalwar in Hindi and in Andhra. In Andhra, they even do weddings on Tuesday. Contrarily, Chennai, they don't even buy anything. How can it? These are all various unwanted beliefs. He's saying, forget it. Don't worry. I am there, right? You just have to pray me. That is what it is said. And what do you mean by... And after this, let's see 18.67. What does it say? Hare Krishna. Idam tenata pashkaya na bhattaya kadachana na cha shushu save vakyam na cha mamyo abhyashyati. Hare Krishna.
This confidential knowledge may not be explained to those who are not austere or devoted or engaged in devotional service. Not for the one who is envious of me. Hare Krishna.
So he's very clearly telling this kind of useless person who does not even not explain, right? So Krishna clearly says, someone who's not austere, you never trust or never do anything is what Krishna is very clearly telling. And such a person, one who is envious of me, why would he say? We already saw, right? Why Krishna chose Arjuna? Because he was non-envious. Same. Who want to explain about Krishna to someone who is envious? So that is what he is saying. And in 18.68, let's see, Hare Krishna. Ya idam paramam guhyam mad bhakteshva bidashyati bhaktim mai param kritva mame vaishyati ashamshayah. Hare Krishna.
Mataji, and the padam marachitrukum.
Somebody can read from the picture inside. It's there here. In the picture itself, the content is there. You can read.
For one who explains the supreme secret to the devotees, pure devotional service is guaranteed. And at the end, he will come back to me. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Even if you buy a product, you have only warranty, which means they will replace. But Krishna is giving the guarantee. Guarantee means, complete. Warranty means repair. Here it means replacement, right? So Krishna is giving that guarantee. No one can give you this guarantee, including parents, right? They'll give you moral support, but can they give guarantee? No. Right? So let's hear what 18.69 he says. Hare Krishna. Nacha tasman manushyesu kamme priya kritamatha bhavita nacha me sasman anya priya karobhuvi. Hare Krishna.
There is no servant in this world more dear to me than he. Nor will there ever be one more dear. Hare Krishna.
So he's telling, for someone who does not have, a belief, don't explain. But for someone who's doing this devotional service, for someone who's giving this knowledge, right? Jnana Dhyan is someone who is surely doing that devotional service. And there will be no one who is more dear to me. This is what he is guaranteeing. And let's see what he's saying in 18.70. Hare Krishna. Adyeshyate chaya imam dharmyam samvadam avayuhu jnana chaya jnena tainaham ishtasyamiti mematihi.
Hare Krishna, and I declare that he who studies the scarred conversation worships me by his intelligence. Hare Krishna.
Sacred. So whoever, I declare that who studies a sacred conversation, what is a sacred conversation? The conversation between Krishna and Arjuna is the most sacred conversation. Why? Because that is the most, one of the best conversations. So he's saying that so whoever reads this Bhagavad Gita, right, I declare that he, and worships me by his intelligence, I declare that such a person, he wants him, right? And I declare that, so he's, it's a continuation. There is no servant who's more dear. Who is that for someone who's reading this Bhagavad Gita? So he is concluding that. What does he say in 18.71? Hare Krishna. Shraddha vananusu yascha shrinu yadapi yonarah sopi muktah subhal lokan prapnu punya karmanam. Hare Krishna.
One who listens with faith and without envy becomes free from sinful reaction and attains to the planets where the pious dwell.
Hare Krishna. Clearly says, Hare Krishna, one who listens to faith and without envy, without, that's what it means, anasuya, right? Automatically attains the planets where the pious live, which means either spiritual world, if not, at least he will reach the Swargaloka. And what does Arjuna say immediately? Arjuna uvacha nashto mohah smritir labdha tvat prasadam mayachuta stitosmi gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Arjuna said, my dear Krishna, O infallible one, my illusion is now gone. I have regained my memory by your mercy, and I am now firm and free from doubt, and am prepared to act according to your instructions. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, thank you. So in the 10th chapter itself, he sang about Krishna, right? Param Brahma Param Dhamma Pavitram Idam Uttamam Tyaktha Bhagamam Vaigunyam Susukam Gugum Kartamam. So what does he say? Right? Parabrahma. So you are the thing. Purusham Shashvatam Divyam Adidevam Majambibum. So clearly he says, Param Brahma, Parandama. You are the biggest, you know, you are the Paramam, you are the spirit, you are in the spiritual world. In the Dhamma is spiritual world. Param Brahma, you are the super soul, right? And Pavitram Idam Uttamam, right? Pavitram, you are so pure. Purusham Shashvatam Divyam, you are so permanent. You are always been there, right? Susukam Divyam Kartavam. So what does it mean? You are everywhere, you are there, right? You are the ultimate. He accepts him, but now what he says, all my doubts are removed, and you have your ultimate, is what he is saying. So 18.74, you can read.
Sanjaya said, thus I have heard the conversation of two great souls, Krishna and Arjuna, and so wonderful is that message that my hair is standing on end.
He's so happy, right? He's just expressing how emotional Sanjaya is. Look at the mood of Sanjaya against Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra is also hearing the same version, but Sanjaya is a devotee. So he's feeling so, you know, he's feeling. And he continues in 7.5.
But Master Vyasa, I have heard these most confidential talks directly from the master of all mysticism, Krishna, who was speaking personally to Arjuna. Hare Krishna.
He says, I'm so happy because the master of mysticism, Krishna, speaks personally to Arjuna. Thankfully, because of Vyasa, mercy of Vyasa, you know, he's so down to earth, right? Spiritual master is Vyasa. He doesn't say, Vyasa gave. He's so down to earth and he's explaining. And he continues, O King, as I repeatedly recall this wondrous and holy dialogue between Krishna and Arjuna, I take pleasure being thrilled at every moment. He's so happy. He's saying that, you know, I'm so excited. I'm so thrilled, right? O King, I remember this wonderful thing. I'm stuck with even great wonder and I rejoice again and again. He says, I just can't tolerate. You know, I'm just so thrilled and I am enjoying this. So he is saying, you know, that I am so happy. And because of that, you know, I am so thrilled and I am rejoicing everything again and again. I'm so happy that nowhere, you know, I can stop. I'm so excited is what he is saying. And finally, you know, there is one shloka, which is a concluding shloka. I told you, right, the bumper offer of having Arjuna and Krishna. This is what he will say. And this is the last shloka. I request each one of you all to memorize. It's a beautiful shloka. Hare Krishna, it's like this. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishno, Yatra Pato Danutanha, Tatra Shir Vijayo Bhutir, Dhruvanitir Madir Mama. Wherever there's Krishna, the master of all mystics, and wherever there is Arjuna, the supreme archer, there will certainly be four things. What is that? Opulence, right? Victory, extraordinary power, and morality. This is my opinion. Sanjaya is concluding. He says, this is what it is. The combination, right? This combination of Krishna and Arjuna, if it is there, you'll have opulence, everything, victory, extraordinary power, and morality. So it's a beautiful, lovely, most interesting chapter. I hope you enjoyed. And you had one question. Let me address that question and I'll take more questions. You all can meanwhile type the question. So one question is false ego. So before that, vancha kalpa darubhyascha kripa sindubhya eva cha atidana pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namah. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. False ego is what I am the doer, right? Many times we don't understand I am the body, I am the soul. You tell, right, this is my house, this is my thing, my phone, don't touch this. All these are examples. The moment we think we are not a part of Krishna and we think we are ourselves and everything is ours, right? As I explained to you, Sambhudim is Krishna. He's the only person who is dependent, independent. We are all Asambhudim, which means we are totally dependent. But if we don't believe that, then we are all in false ego. I hope I have answered. Hare Krishna. And Ritu, sorry, I was holding you. Can you please unmute and ask your question?
Hare Krishna, Madhaji.
Hare Krishna, dear.
So my doubt was in that, I don't remember which verse, but that verse, it is said that we should work, perform work without neither love nor hate, right? So shouldn't we serve our parents and Krishna with love?
Okay, so there is one thing which I gave an introduction. Between love, Prishma, everywhere he talks about love. See, he has love for Radharani, he has love for Yudhishthira. So what is about love and hate is basically when it comes to parents or anyone, not only parents, to everyone, you should have that compassion as a devotee. But your love should not become attachment. I'll give you an example. Now, if you love your child, you'll tell, okay, what do you want to study? I'm just giving an example, right? She says, I want to do engineering, right? You say, no problem, good. And you tell the benefit of engineering is this as a parent, the disadvantage. But you will also have some parents who say, I love you so much. I wanted to be a doctor. For my sake, you become a doctor. Na? Please. Na? So you still love and you do. But is that genuinely only love? It is love. But you want to achieve your goal through children. See, children have to study. Go up is different. Same way parents, right? You must love your parents and do. But what you're doing is whether you love, whether you hate, whether you like or not, you do it as a matter of duty. You don't get into doing something with the expectation. You don't serve your mother with a feeling that, okay, I'm serving my mother, tomorrow she's going to transfer her property to me. No, right? You understand, without any motive. Will you do out of love? Yes, you will do it out of love, 100%. Because you need to have compassion. That is what the whole story is there, right? But what you are supposed to do is, you have to do it as a duty, even if you don't like. You don't talk about mother. Let me just go and bounce little. Everybody creeps about the mother-in-law, right? No, I hate her. But still, whether you like or not, whatever duty you have to do, you do, right? You don't get emotional, but you do it as a duty. You have a friend and enemy, we will still see a difference. That's where we are. See, even I will also see a difference. So I can't treat a friend and an enemy equally, right? Even among friends, we have these shades. But the Uttama Adhikari is someone who doesn't differentiate. So if your answer question is, should we differentiate or not? My answer is, it's not that should we. Can we reduce this differentiation factor? We often tell that I will forgive and forget, right? But after 5 years, we'll tell, you know, you made that mistake. Na? I forgave you and I forgot also. Hare, you've forgotten, then why are you repeating it? Have you not come across people telling that, you know what, I completely forgot whatever mistakes you have done. And you will list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, sorry, right? So that is what it is. And I'm just stretching your answer a little bit to make you understand and give you an explanation as far as I can. This, should you love? Yes, you should. Because Krishna always tells love. But he says, still do your duty. One more example. Father has to take care of the children. But if the father is a judge and if the son has done murders, now what will he do? Should he take care as a son and release him or should he punish him? Which one will come first? Yeah. So he will punish him, and then probably he can still fight for the son and try and take in the next school. So what am I telling is, duty comes first, right? Love is there. It's not that the father loves him less, but the duty has to dominate over love. So that is the point which is reiterated. I hope I have clarified, Hare Krishna. And Vaibhav, Aurora, you joined a little late. Did you enroll? Because I personally sent a reminder in the night on the level 2. Hare Krishna. I hope all of you have enrolled. And also, Rintu, you said you had a challenge in timing. We will probably be introducing more time. So just don't go blindly. Keep the options open. If you have an alternate time, you know, you should definitely join and be a part of it. Yeah. Otherwise, till then, you can keep enrolling yourself for the next level. Some questions I heard is, can you again attend one more session of this? Yes, you can, but you need to enroll and you can. You're most welcome. And second question I heard is, will I be teaching? Yes, most probably I will be teaching level 1, 3 p.m. Level 2, I don't take. You have an expert teacher, but we will be there coming in and out for telling you all stories there in that session. I really enjoyed the journey. If you all have any queries, please write. Otherwise, I will hand over this to Mohandas Prabhu. And he will give a demo on how to, you know, register yourself. Is there anything else? And is there any other doubts you all have? No other doubt? Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It was an awesome journey for me too. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna.